Okay, let me go a little into the secret of bhakti. How does bhakti arise in the human heart? This is also given in our bhakti shastras. Bhakti rasamrita sindhu, bhakti rasayanam, they speak of this. You know, what sparks of bhakti in the human heart? It is a dharana of bhagavad bhav. If our mind can make a dharana of the bhav of Bhagavan, then it will spark off divine love in your heart. The heart cannot remain quiet then. When you know His nature, immediately it will melt. This dravibhuta chitta characterizes, the mind will melt away. It is not like the jnani's mind, you know, it stays like the witness. The bhakta melts. So this will naturally happen if you can make a dharana of His bhav in your mind. So how elevated must be that mind if I should be able to conceive of His bhav? How should I be? See, this is the great secret of bhakti. If I can perfectly meditate on the nature of the Lord, on His bhav towards me, can I keep quiet after that? When I know His nature and His bhav, my heart will respond immediately. That is bhakti. And this comes only by His grace. How can you know Him, think of Him without His grace? There is that beautiful Bangla song, you know. Tumi nahi dile dekha, ke tumai dekhite paaye. Tumi na dakile kache, shohoje ki chitto dhaye. If you do not reveal yourself, who can know you? And if you do not wish it, can my mind just rush like that towards you? And very beautiful another paragraph is there. Mone re bujhai eto, tumi vakko monatito, tabu pran vyakulito, tumare dekhite chai. I try to convince my mind so much that tumi vakko monatito, you are beyond speech and mind and everything. But my pran is vyakul for you. It only wants to see you, your form. This is the state of bhakta. You want to see that supreme being in this particular beautiful form. See, if you cannot get rid of name and form in samadhi, there is no need of getting rid of name and form in samadhi. Just focus on the Lord. Because His mind is beyond name and form, it will lift you to that level. Just meditating on the physical form of Thakur or Ma will lift you to their state of mind. This is the secret of bhakti. So you see, it is available to us. All this knowledge is available to us. The thing is to do it. For that, the most important thing is to manufacture the sattvic mind. If we are taking in all sorts of things from the, you know, this world, a mixture of bhavs. So, a bhakta is very sensitive. Only a very sensitive person can become a bhakta. So it doesn't correlate with you. So a little distance. Thakur ki bolten, kothai amra dhyan korbo, mone bone kone. A little withdrawal within and concentrating on Him there. If we can do this in a concentrated way, it will spark off bhakti in our heart. Tar bhaver dharana asha soja kaj noy. It is not easy. It comes only by His grace. We must be prepared and ready to receive that grace. We must prepare ourselves. A very sattvic, pure mind and His grace will come in. That's the preparation required of us. So bhakti is a perfect possibility in every human mind. In fact, the human heart is meant for the Lord. After all our experiences of life, this is what you will understand. This mixture, this world is a mixture of things. I want the pure essential love in itself. So I will turn towards the Lord. No bhav of this world can satisfy the bhakta. That is why he has become the bhakta. Only the supreme can satisfy. So this is the nature of love. Your ability to catch bhagavad bhav in our heart is the secret of bhakti. This comes only after a lot of practice. That's why never leave spiritual practice. No matter how difficult a period you're going through, only spiritual practice is the only thing which saves us. This great treasure in our heart will only come through spiritual practice, sadhana. So generating sattvic mind and waiting for him to come into our heart through sadhana. This is what the bhakta perpetually keeps doing. He is busy doing this through all his activities.